Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel. I kind of want to do something a little different, and so today we're going to do half of my face of how I would do my makeup now, and then half of my face of how I used to do my makeup for the majority of the time. I mean, I guess there was like little changes here and there, but for the majority of the time, like when I was younger, I'm going to try to do half my face how I would normally do it, and then my face of how I would do it, and I'm going to try to like use the same colors and all that for the eyes, and yeah, we're going to try to make it look kind of the same, but not really, because I've done shit completely different. I looked at some of these other videos and I'm like, is that really how you done your makeup? Because like, I use my hand for my foundation. I'm gonna do everything exactly how I used to do it. I will say though, I used to use, it was a drugstore foundation, and I think it was Maybelline. I think I have an old one somewhere. But I don't know. I don't want to use it. I don't want to put my face, because it's probably been in there for a very long time. But it was Maybelline, I think. It was like $5 or something. So I'm just going to use this. Only I'm going to do like different techniques. I didn't have many of these like old, cheaper palettes laying around. But I did have this one. Well, actually, it was my daughter's. She got it for a gift or something. But she ended up giving it to her little sisters to play with. So it's just basically plain makeup, so it might look a little janked up. But if I'm being completely honest, when I was younger, this is kind of what I used, but like bigger pans. I don't know. It was like LA girl and stuff like that, so I don't know. But that's what we're going to be doing today. So let's go ahead and get started. So we're going to do this side how I used to do it, and it wasn't great. So I'm just going to use this foundation for both sides. Oh, that's not my new one. Yeah, I used a whole bottle of this, so if that tells you anything. And I am using the color 222. So I'm just going to go ahead and put this all over my face, and then I will blend it and stuff how I would do it like before. Oh, I didn't put primer on. I would have used. It's okay. It's okay. Because some days I don't use primer. Some days I do, some days I don't. Alright, so today I would use a beauty blender, so I'm just going to do that on this side. Now before, when I would do the makeup or whatnot, I would use my hand. So that's what I'm going to do for this side. Oh my god, I cannot believe I used to do this. Like, this is so weird to me. Oh my. I cannot believe that. I mean, some people, I guess, still do. It's just so weird. It doesn't even feel right to use my hand. It doesn't. Like, I'm trying to like tap it. Because I'm not. It doesn't feel right. And my nose, I can like see like the lines in it. Oh my goodness. So yeah, that's how I would do it before. So I didn't use concealer. So I'm going to put concealer on this side, and not the other side. Like, I was wondering, like, when people done this challenge, like, if they were really actually doing it right, because, should I do it on my nose and stuff? Because I kind of put it in the center. Because now it's going to be like down, and I have to put it in the center of my nose, so that could be kind of wrong. Yeah, but I don't know if people were actually like doing this right when they were doing it, because I mean, they pretty much done everything exactly the same. I mean, not completely, but like, it looked good. And like, seriously, did you really used to do I should use the primer. That's my pores, girlfriend. Should I just put some down my nose? I'm gonna put some down my nose just because it's kind of hard to do like half and half when you have to clearly put it down your nose. So, it looks a little funny, right? I shouldn't have probably put it on my forehead and my nose, but I feel awkward not doing that. I don't know. Like, I do stuff so much differently now that it feels awkward not doing it. Alright, okay, let's go ahead and grab some powder. Okay, I did not powder. I have terribly dry skin, which I still do, so sometimes I don't even powder now, if I'm being completely honest. Like, I will sometimes, but sometimes I don't. I'm gonna go with Cody Airspun. Just put it on, I didn't bake. Okay, I didn't use bronzer. I really did not use anything. I just put foundation on, eyeshadow. I might put like a little powder on my brow. I'll just show you guys. Okay, so let's do eyeshadow now. So my thing before was, like I said, I used these palettes, something like this, similar, not exactly, but similar. And I would do like a brown with a light color in the center. But I didn't use brushes back then. I actually used this. I was like, oh my god, there's actually one here because I don't own one. But it's like broke and I'm not sure how good this will work. So I might just like use a brush but do it. Like I didn't really do like a whole lot of blending and stuff because I don't know. I might be able to use this. Okay, we'll just try it and see how it works out. But I would go. And I wouldn't have like a transition color, nothing like that. I would just go in with like a dark brown. So I'm just gonna go in with this one right here. I'm gonna try to use this damn thing, but I don't know if it's going to work, y'all, because I like literally have to hold this on. Yeah, this is gonna be so hard. So I'm just put some in my crease. Yeah, I'm gonna have to use a brush. I'm sorry, guys, but that's what I did use, okay? So I'm just gonna, like, use a brush, just, like, this little brush or something. I'm not gonna, like, go fancy because I never would use a brush before. So I've just kind of, like, put it right here. And I'm just putting it in my crease. I wouldn't use any lighter color, any transitional color at all. I would just put it in there. I would just do it just like that, and then I would take a white, like a light color. So I'm just going to go into this light color right there. Okay, and I would take it and I just put it all on the lid. I'm just gonna use this other brush again because that thing ain't working very well. Maybe just use my finger. So I put it all over the lid like that, and I would take that dark shade, put a little bit more in the crease. Like that. Did I really do it like that? Like, was it this bad? Because that doesn't look great to me, but whatever. And then I would take like a little shimmer. I don't know if this right here is like a shimmer. I don't think it is. I think it's just like a white. Is it like a shimmery? But these are like literally the chalk. Damn. Shadow, I don't think mine was even that chalky. Maybe it was. I don't freaking know. So I think that's like a shimmer. It's as close as we're gonna get. It doesn't really look pretty much how I would do it. Yeah, that's it. Just some brown with some white. And then for eyeliner, I never use like liquid or gel or anything like that. This right here was my go-to eyeliner. This was Maybelline New York Expert Wear. Yeah, I remember. It's hard to like see it because it's like wore off, but Expert Wear, yeah, and the color Velvet Black, I think. Yeah, Velvet Black. And I would take a lighter like this and I would light it. And then I would blow on it to make sure it wasn't too hot. And then I would just like this to my finger to make sure. And then I would take it and put it in my my eye. And then I would take a line.
Oh! No!
Okay, excuse me. But yeah, that's how I would do my shadow and my hair in my freaking face. My shadow and my eyeliner. I would use this, and I still really like this eyeliner. I'm just more of a like gel type now. I don't even know if I made my wing that high. I think it was like maybe a little bit shorter. It was really little because I wasn't really doing wings. I didn't really know how back then. So I don't even know if it was like that long, but before we put mascara or anything like that on, I'm going to go ahead and do what I would do now. And today, let's see, what palette should I go into? I don't know if I'm going to go into this one or the Blood Sugar palette. So I haven't used this palette for a while. I was going to use Blood Sugar, but I know you guys have probably seen like a ton of looks with that palette. I mean, if you might not, I don't know what you guys want to see. But today I'll just go in with the, which one is this? So today I'm just going to go in with the Morphe Boss Babe palette because I'm pretty sure you guys have probably seen a lot of looks with the Blood Sugar. I don't know. But I'm just going to go in with it today. The very first shade I'm going to is this lighter one that's right here. And then I would go into this one. It's just a little bit darker. I don't want to put a whole lot on at the beginning, so I'm just going to knock some of the excess off. I'm going to focus this more into the crease. So I'm mainly putting that darker shade on the outer, but then I'll like bring it in a little. And I'm going to go into this shade, and then I'm going to go into this one, and we're going to put this in the crease as well. We're just going to darken this up. Okay, and I'm going to go into that dark brown. Actually, I'm going to use a lower brush. I'm just going to put it right here on the outer and the crease. And I'm just going to bring it in just a little, but for the most part, it's going to be on the outer, so it's going to be darker on the outer. You could cut the crease if you wanted. Or you could just put it on like this. Normally, I don't cut the crease. I just put it on. I don't know if I should cut the crease for this, or maybe I should just cut the crease. Just, you know, because, hey, this to this, right? So, I don't know. Maybe I should just be like, yeah, see? Progress. It's like so hot up here, and I'm like, we're drinking fucking coffee. I gotta have coffee. Okay, so I'm just going to take some concealer. do have to kind of like look in the mirror for this. That's why I don't do a lot of cut creases on my channel, because I feel like I have to be so close up in the mirror. Sorry, my camera stopped. Setting spray. Spray it on my brush. This white shimmer right here, because I'm trying to get it to kind of look like of how I used to do it and how I do it now. So I could have put another color in here, but we're going to try to keep it kind of the same. I'm just going to take that brown. And kind of just run it below that. Now that we have that done, that's kind of how it's looking. Way different than this one. I wouldn't do any shadow on the bottom over here. But I am going to on this side, so I'm going to go into the very lightest shade, which is this one that we used. So I got some ColourPop goodies coming because I know there was somebody that had mentioned that they wanted to see some ColourPop stuff. So I got some ColourPop coming. Oh! But yeah, I got some ColourPop makeup coming, some of their new releases, some goodies. So yeah, be watching for that. Also, I'm gonna have a ColourPop giveaway, so. Oh yeah, I kinda wanna do an intro kind of thingy and tell you guys like more about me, where I came from, what I wanna achieve, what I wanna do with this channel. I wanna kinda go all into detail, so I was wanting to do it today, but I just didn't wanna like put this as a downer because, you know, my life was not always great, and I also don't want people to like feel sorry for me because, of course, obviously, I'm not living like that now. But yeah, I just want to kind of like let y'all know. I think it's very important that we have an open like relationship where we can talk and, you know, share ideas and things like that. So yeah, I'm gonna do that this week as well. And also, we're also gonna have the giveaway and some ColourPop goodies and some other goodies. There was a company that I really want to talk about that I've heard a few complaints on, and I'm kind of curious if you guys have heard it. It's called Be Perfect, I think, Cosmetics. They have the Carnival palette and stuff, and I've seen it, and like that is the best looking palette I have seen in a very, very long time. Like, I want it so bad. But it's really expensive. It's $58.95, and if you don't spend $60, you got to pay for shipping, which to the U.S. is $10, so... And obviously, if I'm only paying $58.95, I'm not paying $60 to get free shipping. So, you know, they had like a pre-sale thing going on and whatnot. And a bunch of people saying that they haven't got their stuff. And I kind of was like, just ruining their thing. Like, hey, your palette like, looks gorgeous. I would love, 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 love to have it. But I'm kind of scared where people haven't got their items yet. They went back like, oh, it's only 7-10 days. Well, I had a couple women. I'm going to go into the shade right here. I had a couple women reach out and was like, yeah, I got screwed over. Like, I haven't got my stuff yet. And I'm like, oh my gosh, that's so terrible. And the one said that last time she ordered the last palette that they came out with, it took her 3 months to get it. So she was like, okay, well maybe shit's changed now. And she done it again, or ordered the, you know, the new palette, and during the pre-sale and still hasn't received it. And I'm like, oh man, I hope they like don't do that shit to her again, Because no company should take 3 months to get you your damn palette. Obviously, I know that, you know, it's in the UK and stuff, so it can take a little bit of time. I know that, and plus they said it wasn't going to start shipping until certain dates. So, I mean, obviously you're going to have to wait till those dates before they start shipping. So, I don't know. I don't want to, like, say anything bad about it, but if you've ever dealt with it or anything, that company, please let me know down below so I can know, because I'm not trying to wait 3 months to get my palette, you know? Alright, now I'm going to go back into that lighter shade and kind of blend these two out. Grab some highlighter really quick. I've never used highlighter before. I know I didn't use anything. I was just like plain, like that's it. I'm sure a lot of you have like not used all this shit before, right? So I'm just gonna put some highlighter right here. Like I could not imagine doing my makeup without this now, you know? I don't know why I'm putting like powder on right now. Okay. Oh my god, I look so funny. Like, can I just? I got to. Okay. Now, eyeliner. So with eyeliner, I would use the Maybelline New York Eye Studio in the color Black is Black. And for this eye look, I'm not really going to put it on top. I'm just going to put like a straight line. I'm not going to do a wing for this look. And I'm going to put some at the bottom. So I'll do this really quick. Okay. I think that's good enough because obviously I'm not going to wear this all day, but it'll work, right? The eyeliner's not perfect, but it'll work. You guys kind of see what I'm trying to do here. Sorry, I don't know, was it like really, my lighting was fucked up, wasn't it? Okay, so since we got that done, I'm sweating. Let's go ahead and put some blush on. I didn't use blush, so I'm going to go in with the Ofra Pink Satin Blush. And a little bit of the one that's in the Bahu palette. I'm just going to kind of dab it. Kind of like stick on it and then blend it. Oh my god, guys, I just put blush over here. Oh my god. Oh well. I'm gonna go in with the Ofra and Francesca palette. I'm gonna grab some of this, give a dab of that. Brush like this and put it at the bottom of my nose and then kind of run it down it. Obviously, my nose will look better if I done the other side, but I didn't use bronzer back then. I'm going to take a little bit under my lip on this side and above it right up on this side. Okay, so I know there's like a big difference. I know you guys can tell, right? This is how I used to wear makeup. This is how I'd wear it now. Okay, wait, I'm not even done yet. And I just always put powder in this one, so I'm gonna do this one how I would normally do it. I hadn't put my mascara on, and I did use mascara, probably different kinds back then, but this right here has been one of my go-tos. Okay, So obviously I have been starting to get into lashes a little bit. So if I really wanted to go all out, I would grab my a set of lashes and put on. But I'm not going to do that today. I'm just going to leave it like this. Alright, so anyway, how I did my brows. Okay, so I would take a brow thing. Like one of those brush things or whatever I had. I don't think I've ever done much with my brows. I don't think I've done anything with them, truthfully. I do remember putting powder, so I'd go into like a shadow. So I'd like go brown and maybe like a little black, kind of mix it. And just kind of like run it through. That's pretty much all I would do with the brows. That was it. I would just put a little bit of powder in it, kind of bring them a little to life. And that was it. Okay. Now, lips. I feel like spray my face. For my other side, I would just simply put some like gloss or something on. I might put a little bit of lipstick on. Anyway, I would just take like a cheap like lipstick or gloss. So I'm just gonna take this right here and I'd put it on my lip. And then I would go in with the shadow that I used, because I hated wearing lipstick because it always came off on everything. I would go into the shadow that I used and I would put it over it. So I would take like a brush. And I would take and put and that's how I would do my lipstick. I hated the way lipstick moved and the way it came off and everything, so I thought, well, hey, if I just put some powder over it or something like that, then it won't be as like sticky or move around as much. So that's what I've done with that. Is that everything? I think that's about everything. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I think so. I think we're done. So yeah, I want to go into like a little detail with you next time, like on the next video or something. And then I want to give you guys some ColourPop goodies. All you have to do is be like subscribed, and then I'll make a video announcing whatever you're gonna win, and then you have to comment under the badge. A lot of people that are even subscribing don't even enter, so your chances are very, 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 very good of winning. So yeah, just wanted to put that out there. I hope you guys enjoyed this crazy transformation from when I was 12, 13 years old, 14, 15, I think I even was up to like 18 or so, even maybe longer, I don't know, to what I would wear now. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. If you guys did, make sure to go ahead and hit that like button. I'm like sweating, like look, I don't know if you guys see, it's like so hot there. So okay, so if you guys like this look, make sure to hit the like button, and if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe here to the channel. Join us, let's be a little fam. I want to bring so much to this channel. Like the majority of it's going to be about makeup, but I want to bring so much more into it. So, I don't know, I have big plans, so hopefully you guys come, subscribe, join, and yeah, I will see you guys next time.